এক্সট্রা টাইম।
মিষ্টি কথা, বাংলার নতুন মিষ্টি।
Well, it's quite evident we have the quality of players that we have already, plus we know very well how to play in our conditions, you know, how we need to win test matches here. So look, it's not easy for us as a home side as well when, you know, conditions are challenging, when the ball's spinning. You know, we've also found it difficult in the past, but we are a team that looks for answers and not excuses. So maybe that's the reason why we keep improving, and you know, we've been able to win so many test matches. We don't take anything for granted, for sure. We can very well be, you know, losing 4 or 5 wickets a session, so we know that as well as a team, and we work pretty hard on our game also, even though we play in our own conditions and we've grown up playing in these conditions. So I think the mindset is key for us, and that's to win every game that we play and not focus on what the conditions are on display. We look to find answers rather than excuses.
Last time you played, what happened? Took a pitch and the long monsoon that was there sort of making the pitch preparation. So do you see a lot of moisture? If so,
do you
play
at the same level? Yeah, look, it'll have to be a decision taking tomorrow morning, because the pitch can very well change with so much sun over the last 3 days as well. There has been a bit of moisture that's gone into the pitch, but yeah, it should be a good pitch to play on for seamers initially. Then the ball does tend to turn here. The batsmen, if they get in on the first 2 days, can get runs as well, quick outfield. So we'll have to play good cricket regardless of how the pitch behaves, and exactly the point I mentioned, we'll have to adapt very quickly to what's on our hand, and if it's damp, so be it. You know, if it's hard, it's good to bat on. We'll have to bat well or bowl well, whatever it is, you have to do that particular discipline well. So yeah, none of us know what the pitch is going to behave like tomorrow morning, and we'll have to think of the best combination possible. Look, the importance of every game has become that much more. You know, in situations that in a 3-match series you probably would have played out a draw, teams are going to go for wins and get those extra points. So I think it's great for test cricket. The matches are going to be that much more exciting is what we all feel, and we can already experience that. We have to be absolutely professional in every session that we play. So yeah, I think it's much more demanding on the players now, which is a good thing, because it'll keep the standard of test cricket high. Plus, yeah, these are the only things we have experienced so far and noticed in terms of changes. If you would have asked me to make the points table, I would give double the points for an away test win. That is something that I would definitely would have liked to see, but maybe after the first edition.
Yeah,
Vikrant,
generally the teams and you all played here, so the cricket, have a perception, an idea of how a pitch should behave on his behavior. This rain has been very
strong. Well, I think more or less our team is settled. I don't think it's going to play that big a factor, because when the pitch is damp, it turns as well. So it's not like, you know, only seamers are predominantly going to be effective on this pitch all 5 days. Everyone will have to play their roles. Unless you have a pitch which has total grass coverage, only then you think of changing your combination too much, because you do know that it's going to dry out at some stage, and you can't go predominantly one-sided in your attack and then not have the balance. So we are pretty balanced in our team composition, and if any changes need to be made looking at how the pitch might behave on the first 3 days, then we'll do so. But we don't see any major things to think about looking at the pitch here.
Right.
It's always a happy problem with whatever combinations you play, they work with. But like for some of it could be the other 4 or 5 in Sydney, and then probably some combinations of very easy that has been actually also come back in the second season against the team. Like, at what you tell someone like to be like, with the injury, did he lose something or it's purely combination?
No, it's purely a combination. A lot has been spoken, a lot has been said about this system that we have followed over the last 2 years. The only thing that matters to us is wanting to win as many games as we can, and we've been able to do that. We have the least losing percentage in the last 3 years, and there's a good reason for that. So we don't want to be rigid in our thinking, saying this is how we need to go forward. We're obviously very flexible, but as I said, it can't be possible if the team doesn't buy into it. And the guys have bought into it, and people are just wanting to contribute. No one's self-centered, no one's thinking about only themselves. Everyone's thinking about what I can do for the team. Fast bowlers are happy to contribute during a game when they're not bowling so much. They're happy to run in and, you know, bowl their hearts out. So same the case with Kuldeep as well. He understands what the situation is. He understands that in India, obviously, Jadeja and Ashwin are going to be our first choices also, because they give you so much more with the bat as well. So, as I said, it's for us, it's about finding the best balance as a team and purely combination based.
But we have seen that by hitting the balls around in the net, is it a strategy to tackle the spinners in the
counting track? No, I just wanted to have some fun today. I don't do everything with strategy all the time. It's important to enjoy yourself as well. I think on the pitches that we play, I haven't seen anyone get so much seam movement apart from him. Yes, internationally many bowlers do because of the pitches, but I think on flat pitches he has the ability to pick you wickets in situations that feel absolutely dead, and that's why he's such an important bowler for us. That's why we've wanted to manage his workload very precisely, all the fast bowlers. You know, he's someone who can change the complexion of the game totally when you don't see it coming. So that's the kind of skill he possesses. And now he is taking the responsibility. Now we don't need to push Shami anymore. We don't need to tell him, come on, you got to get up and bowl this spell for us. You know, he wants the ball. He understands the situation when he's given the ball, especially in the second innings when, you know, situations are difficult. He comes in and does the job every time. So it's great. I mean, people are, as I said, taking responsibility at different situations in the game, which is amazing to see. And his skill is obviously there for everyone to see. It's not a surprise anymore to all of us that he gets the ball to do that much more than others, you know, in conditions that don't really offer you much. So, yeah, he's blessed with that skill naturally, but it's the mindset that's changed now. And he, according to me, he's in the best space right now as a bowler.
We'll take the final 3 questions, one from the right and one from the left.
Yeah, it's how they played in the first innings was very good. I mean, it's, you have to be positive when the wicket's nice and easy to bat on. You have to try and get as many runs as possible, and that's exactly what they did. So I would say the first 3 or maybe even 4 days of the game, the wicket was hardly doing anything. You know, after 3.5 days, it started to turn a little bit, and then on day 5, we really got into our own. So, yeah, like, we expected that. We expected teams to come out and try and be positive against us, and we held our own. We held our own in the second innings and put up again 400 runs for them to gun down again. So, look, we are going to be put under pressure, even though we're playing at home. But it's about how we come back into the game and then put double the pressure on the opposition again, and you know, then tell them, let's see if that can be executed again. So that's basically what Test cricket is. You have to come back in the second innings and do the job again. It doesn't end in one innings, but yeah, the approach was quite expected.
Final question. For Indian pitches, we have seen unknown spinners succeeding against us whenever they have troubled us. They are the unknown spinners compared to their senior counterparts. So what are your views about Keshav Maharaj and Muthu Sami and the last test we have struggled against the unknown spinners? So, you know, what are your thoughts about the opponent's speed for each time?
Last test we played here. Yeah, I mean, they have to be good if they're playing South Africa. I mean, they've made it to the test team, so I'm sure they have enough skill level. Keshav, I've seen for a while. Keshav is their main spinner. Dane Peat has played in the past in India. Muthuswamy is more of an all-rounder is what we know. So, look, you can't take anyone lightly, but you can't go into the game thinking you're nervous against anyone. You have to be confident of your own skill. At the same time, you have to find the right balance of respecting that bowler but putting the bad ball away. So, finding that balance is a responsibility for all the batsmen. Yes, the test that we lost here, these things are going to happen. You have to take it in your stride. And we have absolutely no regrets but only learnings from those games. And if you see our performances after that, we haven't lost the test at home. So, for us, it's about not being complacent and just going out there and doing the job properly.
Final, Joseph.
Yeah. And now that Rohit has played well,
I mean, it's overflowing. It's not being filled. Come on, give the guy a break now. It's, you know, he's done well. Let him enjoy his batting at the top of the order. Let him just, you know, have fun like he does in white ball cricket and stop focusing on what's Rohit going to do in tests. I think he's in a great space. He's playing really well and he looked relaxed in the first game, which is great to see. All the experience that he's accumulated over the years, you know, came to the fore. So he's feeling absolutely at home at the top of the order. And, you know, for us as a team, it's a huge bonus because if you saw the second innings, the way he's able to take the tempo of the game forward, that allows the bowlers an extra hour and a half or 2 hours maybe to bowl the opposition out. So, look, if a guy like him at the top of the order plays the way he does, you know, he did in the last game, then we are going to be in situations to go for victories in most of the test matches. So, we're all very happy for him and I think it's time to just move ahead from his spot at the top of the order and just let him enjoy his batting.
লেটেস্ট নিউজ আর এক্সক্লুসিভ ভিডিওর সঙ্গে আপডেট থাকতে এখনই সাবস্ক্রাইব করুন আমাদের ইউটিউব চ্যানেল। বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করতে ভুলবেন না জানো।